Hey everyone, so in this video we are going to be reviewing the Faber Castell Classicolor colored pencils and the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth colored pencils. We are going to be coloring in this piece because I thought it's more interesting than just seeing me do some shading and all of that stuff. So in this video I'm going to be using the Faber Castell Classicolor colored pencils. I was just trying to show you what's written on the pencil and all of that, and I couldn't, so yeah, it didn't focus. I'm sorry for that. Here you can see the colors that come in the 36 count set. I've got for both the 36 count set, and I really like it actually. It has a really nice range of colors, especially for a beginner. I started out using the Faber Castell Classic Color colored pencils since I've been like 2 years old, so it's really a really nice set to just start out with, and a very affordable one as well. It's the cheaper one of both. I don't know actually the prices at the moment, but I can write it down in the description below. The Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth have been with me for about 5 to 6 years. So I've been using both for a few years, and I think I'm very capable of doing this review about them. Today we're gonna, as said before, use the Classicolor colored pencils from Faber-Castell, a very nice brand that I actually love. And then in the next video, the second part of this one, we're gonna be using the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth colored pencils, because I didn't want one of the videos to be too long. And I wanted you to really see the entire process of this piece coming together and the other one, which I'm not going to tell you what's going to be. Make sure to follow me on Instagram, because you always get a bit of insight and extra sneak peeks to the stuff I'm doing at the moment. The link will be down in the description below. And I'll let you watch a little bit, and then I'll give you my review on these pencils.
Thank you.
So the classic colored pencils by Faber Castell are, as I said before, a really nice set to start out with, as they have a soft core, but at the same time they don't break as easily because of this anti-break system Faber Castell has with all of their pencils. So it's really nice to color in details as well. It's not just good for blending, it's good for doing the details, and you'll see that when I get to her eyes, for example, or the lips. They hold a nice point and they don't need resharpening every 2 seconds like other pencils do. The color vibrancy is nice, but like it could have been better. I mean, the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth colored pencils are a little bit more vibrant than these ones, and a little bit more like buttery, if you understand what I'm saying. It's like you can blend a little bit easier, but the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth pencils, you have to resharpen them every 2 seconds literally if you want to do something like hair. Like you can see at the end of the video, I'll be coloring in her hair, and I'll be coloring in some individual strands, and you can really see the strands individually, and you didn't have to resharpen the pencil to do that. With the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth pencils, I would have had to resharpen like 3 to 4 times while doing the hair. So I really like the Faber Castell ones for hair, for details, and for all of for fur when you're drawing animals. So it's really nice. So it's not like the Faber Castell Polychromos ones or the Prismacolor Premier ones, as these are really high-end colored pencils and are way more expensive than these ones. So in my opinion, the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth colored pencils are a really nice set to just for like students or for someone who's just starting out. It's really nice to practice with, and that's why I still keep them around actually, because when I'm doing something where I don't anywhere I'm experimenting and don't really know how it's gonna turn out, I don't like to waste my Faber Castell Polychromos ones or the Prismacolor Premier. So I actually use those to sketch in my sketchbook or just do something where I'm not really sure about how it's gonna turn out, or just experimenting and having fun a little bit.
Wait on other people to be what you've been called to be. You can't wait on their affirmation. You can't wait on their approval. You can't wait on their support. Sometimes you've just got to run and look behind you and say, everybody who wants to run, run. But I can't stop running because you're not running with me. Listen to me, hear me. You can't stop chasing your dream just because somebody in your life won't chase it with you. You can't stop believing in yourself just because somebody in your life won't believe in you. You can't stop chasing the dreams of your life just because when you know when you do it, you're gonna have to do it all by yourself. We'll be right back.
if it's value that you're looking at, then the Faber-Castell Classic Color colored pencils are actually the winner in this versus video, because they offer the best quality for the price you pay. I mean, like, the color range is really nice. You get all the basic colors you need, and even some pastels and a few metallic tones in the 36 set. While the Polycolor from Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth have more like toned colors, like a little bit more serious colors. So if you're actually going for something realistic or in that matter, then you might actually go with the Polycolors, because they just have these muted tones you might actually look for. But at the same time, the Faber-Castell Classic Color pencils do have some muted tones, so you could just mix and match a little bit and then have just the same colors as the Koh-i-Noor Hardtmuth ones. I just wanted to give you a little tip on this piece. You can see me adding, and instead of blending to the white of the paper, I'm blending to yellow, because I just learned that actually from Draw with Jazz, and he said that it gives you more depth in the piece and a little bit more like saturation when you blend towards another color and not just do it towards the white of the paper. And that's what I did in this painting, drawing, whatever you call it. So yeah, and layering. The Faber-Castell Classic Color colored pencils are actually really good for layering. They layer amazingly, and they do have some wax bloom actually, but it doesn't really bother me, because I'm usually done by that part, so it doesn't really get in the way of creating my pieces. But it might actually bother someone else. There are ways you can get around that, but just so you know. The Koh-i-Noor Polycolor pencils actually do have a little bit of wax bloom as well, but it's like at a more further stage than the Faber-Castell Classic Color ones, so you can actually layer a little bit more than just with these ones, and they blend a little bit better. But again, it's just a thing of preference, and that's just my opinion about both of them. I hope you enjoyed this video, and stay tuned for the one that's coming out next week with the review more focused on the Koh-i-Noor colored pencils. And yeah, make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss out on the next video. And I'll see you then.